Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is the Face Strategist and welcome back to Fallout New Vegas. In this video we'll be taking a look at the New Vegas Bounties 2. We'll just be starting off the mod. In order to actually start it, we're going to be heading to Boulder City. Then from Boulder City, we're just going to go to the quest marker. Now basically this is going to be sort of a let's play slash walkthrough. I already covered the first part of this mod, which was incredibly fun, and now this one is very more detailed. And there are radiant bounties as well, but there are 23 main bounties. And after this, there's the third part. So let's actually go ahead and enter the Boulder City Jail. And there we go, we have three of these guys. So let's actually go ahead and talk to Larry Skull.
What can I do for you, young man?
Okay.
What can I do for you, young?
So why are you running the jail?
Fuck me, that's why. My ass is past retirement. Some colonel used stop loss to keep me running this shitty little jail.
Stop loss?
So many combat ready rangers and troops.
Okay.
Stuck here until the war ends or I drop dick.
They're good in bounty hunters.
We came in here waving the banner and expecting to mold the Mojave into our own image. That ain't exactly the case.
Yeah.
Extracting every man in the burnt out there. The old guard is dead. Thanks to you and to that.
Okay.
I'm afraid of anything or anyone. Somebody's got to put that fear in them. The kind of fear that twists your spine and makes you hesitate. Most of them already know your name. Something.
Okay.
It doesn't matter if it's greed.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk to him again. Where are you from?
California originally, but it's been a long time since.
Okay.
Made a good living at it, too. Wanted me to get in the family business, but I was young and foolish, so I left. Sometimes I wish I stayed up in those. Yeah, but who the fuck am I kidding? I could never stand to be on the bus for too long. Besides, I'd have blown the family fortune on whores and booze. My brother
okay.
On the farm, but I ain't heard from him in years. He's a posse little fuck, so I'd have probably shot him if I went back.
Okay. Quite the character, I like him.
Isn't really an application. More of a brief. I don't really care if you like the NCO.
Mm-hmm.
Just bring in the bad guys and you'll get. Now, if that's an acceptable arrangement.
Yeah, that's fine.
You've got the guts. It's easy money. One thing, though. Unlike these mercenaries, we do pay higher for live bounties.
Mm-hmm.
I understand that you can't lock everyone down, so we also pay the fingers. What? In order to
okay.
Getting these live bounties, gonna issue you a. This little device goes
around
you manage to talk them down to stray off course, and you start prodding them with a nice dose of electricity. Take my word for it, it ain't pretty. Once you get it on, they won't want it. Call it
okay.
A signature that indicates it's your bounty, so don't worry about something. You'll find bounty posters scattered throughout the territory. That's pretty much it. Here's the collar and your light.
Okay, so yeah. So that's basically it, more or less.
What can I do for you?
Okay, you don't have anything else for me.
What do you want?
Oh, you're an arrogant little fucker, aren't you? We mess and learn of this, I just want to know who I'm working with.
I grew up in a small village in Mexico, something else. Relatively safe. There was only five or so
on the okay. Okay.
So they pressed me into slavery. They told me to show honestas industria. It could. I remember what the overseer would say to us at the civil time. Keep you in no benefit. Since I was growing into a strong lad, the overseer's unit was tasked with setting up an alcohol. The rangers ambushed us at night. Most ambushes. After the smoke cleared, I saw one of the others. The guy had his terrible eyes. His ears squirming. I leaned over and I whispered, "Iskipati," into his ear. I joined up with the Desert Rangers at the right age of 14. I appreciate the work you do, Bounty Hunter.
Okay. I need to get going.
What?
Will you provide me with okay, I don't really care. Oh. 16 to 20 dossiers 1 to 5. The Mongol kid. Mongols Boulder City Jail. 250 alive, 100 dead. Once a valued member of the cons, he left the gang to form radical the primary pursuits of drug trafficking, kidnapping. Only this person ever seen the kidnapping. Families, the Mongol kid is physically robust. Nonetheless, remembering that he has a limited tolerance for plane. Okay. So how does that work? This is Arthur Ribbon, the Mongol kid. Okay, that starts the coward for a minute. I guess I can do this by quest, since there are actually quest names. Let's go to Lone Wolf Radio. Okay, are you the Mongol kid? No, you're just a Mongol sentry. So you're not really important. Let's see, patrol. What does it say? Silver and the man with the patrol, we're lucky to have found this place, so I want to make the best out of it. We're gonna inspect the Gold Spring source and see if we can nab a captive. While conducting the reconnaissance, anyways, keep a lookout for that boogeyman bounty hunter everybody's talking about. It doesn't take much to knock off some fiends. Proceeded to say that he, or was it her, took the judge, so don't fuck around, okay. Oh shit, there they are. Okay, so that's the... Holy crap, that's a lot of them. I guess he'll say just Mongol kid. Yeah, fuck off. Okay, there's Victor. Out of all people, Victor. That's actually, there we go. Okay. They want to return, but sure they have footsteps of the Mongol kid approaching. Okay, where is the Mongol kid? Okay, let's actually just try to cripple him. But he said he has little tolerance for pain. There we go. I'm going to put a collar on you, turn yourself in at the Boulder City Jail. There we go. These are basically just great cons. Nothing too special about them. In any case, let us head back to Boulder City Jail. That should be over here. And they'll award us with a nifty 250 caps.
Evening. What can I do for you, young?
There we go. What do you mean, what's the... Oh. Let's wait an hour. Another hour. He's gonna get killed, isn't he? Well, I mean, dude, if I have to escort him all, I'm just not going to fuck around with that. In all honesty. There we go. He turned himself in. Let's talk to Larry Skull.
What can I do for you? Okay.
There we go.
That crybaby couldn't turn himself in fast enough. Wouldn't shut up about his damn injuries. Much more than flesh, apparently. One of the cons wouldn't have.
Mm-hmm.
He got sentenced for 30 years, which means he's going to end up somebody's bitch.
Okay, so that's basically it for the first one.